Hi, I'm Andrea Gridnitsky, Senior Vice President of Global Performance Solutions at Richardson. The topic for this video blog is creating a coaching culture. By now, we know that sales coaching can lead to greater productivity and improved sales results. But how do you transform your company to one that has a true coaching culture? The first tenet is starting at the top. The organization's senior leadership must buy into the value of coaching. They also must hone their own coaching skills. They must hold themselves accountable to coaching and hold their teams equally accountable. The topic of coaching should have its spot on meeting agendas and in corporate communications. Executives should spotlight coaching success. Cascading down, all levels of management should build skills in coaching, but not just in coaching their teams, in giving feedback to their peers. Most people think of coaching as a unilateral action, from boss to subordinate. But coaching is an up, down, and sideways skill. And this is where the concept of coach and culture takes hold. In meetings, interactions, and reviews, team members across the organization should be giving one another feedback. Train teams on how to give and receive feedback. Then make feedback the final agenda item in each interaction, and coaching will take root. Another step is to identify coaching champions, managers in the organization who seek out coaching successes and ensure the stories are told across any medium possible. Finally, coming full circle, senior leadership needs to encourage feedback up. Leaders need to ask for and be open to feedback. This step demonstrates the value placed on coaching. By getting every level of the organization involved in coaching one another and giving feedback, and by making coaching a part of dialogues within and across levels, your teams can establish a coaching culture that will reap the benefits at both personal and organizational levels.